Welcome back, everyone, to the show. We have here today, of course, my favorite co-host, Joey Quivito, and our very special guest today, Rachel from Catahoulas. Rachel, how are we going to get started on our pasta?
All right, we're going to start with 2 cups of flour, and I'm going to use it in this KitchenAid mixer with the paddle attachment, and then 3 eggs.
Those things are really nice. I always wanted one of those.
Oh, I love them.
I've been begging my wife for years for one of those. Mm-hmm.
This is a good one.
It's a good one. I see that.
Christmas is right around the corner. It's perfect. Perfect timing.
Exactly.
And this is going to be really interesting still because Rachel's actually making the pasta from scratch. And
yes. I'm going to put about a teaspoon of salt in there.
A first for our show. Fresh pasta.
Always something new. We love it.
And then I have some garlic. It's actually soaking in this oil, but I'm going to put a little garlic in here. You can add whatever you want to pasta. I'm putting garlic and basil today. You can make it plain or you can put some dried tomatoes or spinach. Add a little bit of this basil.
This is nothing like fresh basil, huh, Jason?
Nothing like fresh herbs, period.
Exactly. We have an herb garden at Catahoulas right out back.
So I have one right behind the restaurant.
I have one too. The summer kind of killed mine, but needs a little attention, but it's still there.
I can't even imagine trying to cook without that herb garden, to be honest.
Rosemary is my favorite.
Yeah. Okay. So I'm just going to mix it together.
So Rachel, while that's mixing together, why don't you tell everybody at home your hours there at Catahoulas in Grand Coteau?
Okay, we're open Wednesday through Saturday for lunch from 11 to 2, dinner from 5 to 9, and then we're open for Sunday brunch from 10 to 2.
Wow.
Yeah. So we're closed Monday and Tuesday.
Monday and Tuesday, definitely closed.
You got to love the little town of Grand Coteau.
Yeah, I love it.
My mom just moved there. She bought a house in Coteau Lakes. I love Grand Coteau.
All the little shops. Just going to add a little bit of water, about a teaspoon or however much you need, just to bring it together.
There's so many different things you can do with the fresh made pasta, huh, Rachel?
Oh, there's so much. Like I said, you can put spinach, you can put tomatoes, sun-dried tomatoes, cheese. Pretty much you can add anything or just make it plain.
And it's fun. You can just play with it, you know, let your mind go.
Okay, and then when it comes together, is there a camera that can kind of see it? When it comes together, you can switch out and put your dough hook in, or you can knead it by hand. I'm not that strong anymore.
Yeah. Since you got a nice equipment, yeah.
I'll use the dough hook. Just let that knead together a little bit. It'll form a ball in there.
Wow.
And really, that's all it is.
Yeah, that's easy enough.
Mm-hmm.
Easy enough for everybody on our show to be able to make it home. So.
Yep, so you let it just go for a couple minutes. I'll just take it out so everyone can see it.
Okay.
Pretty simple.
Yep, and there it is. You can see it's a little bit sticky, but it's not too sticky.
Is that the key to it? Is it like sticky but not too sticky? You don't want it too dry or
you want
wet.
It to be a little bit sticky, but it can't be too sticky.
Okay.
I mean, so that's pretty much the key. And I'm actually going to let this knead just a little bit more.
Okay.
And you should let it rest about 15 minutes between before you roll it. That just makes it better because it gets the elastin property that you need in it.
But. Gotcha. Okay, why don't you tell somebody your menu and stuff while you are waiting for it?
Sure. This dish in particular was actually here before I took over the restaurant, but I didn't know exactly how they made it, so I just read the ingredients and we made it up ourselves. So it's not the exact same dish, but we have a lot of the dishes that they had before. We have a crab meat cheesecake and a seafood Napoleon and things like that. And then we have a lot of dishes that we do ourselves that are new. And I have kind of a different concept. It's like a farm fresh concept. So everything we either grow ourselves or we get from local farms. Well, we try, not everything, but we try. That's the ultimate goal.
It's not always possible.
Exactly. Yeah. But, and then we have a lot of seafood, a few steaks, we have lamb and pork and
things
like that on the menu.
There's not too many restaurants that actually sell lamb anymore, so
and
it's very unique.
I get so many people asking me to do lamb, so I know there's a market out there for it.
Yeah, and in the daytime we have a more lunch-friendly menu. We have it's between $8 and $12, and sandwiches, salads, fresh soups every day, and then dinner is a little bit nicer, and so is our Sunday brunch.
That's a really beautiful restaurant. If you get off of I-49, depending on which way you're coming from, if you come from Opelousas, you want to turn to the left, going to Grand Coteau,
yes,
and then go right around the corner And it's just down the street, right there on your right.
Yes.
Well, it's in the middle of everything, you know, like Lafayette's right down, you know, it's in the middle of between Lafayette and Opelousas,
that's
so
right.
You should get
up, mm-hmm.
a little bit of each crowd.
Yeah, and with the lunchtime, you can come and look at the different shops that we have. There actually are a lot of cute shops in Grand Coteau.
We have a good brunch on Sundays.
Mm-hmm. We have a nice Sunday brunch.
Mm-hmm. And if you want an intimate dinner on Tuesday, Wednesday, Thursdays, I'm sorry, not Tuesday, you're closed Tuesday. Yeah. Wednesday, Thursday, Friday, Saturday, they can come and have a really nice.
And we have a really nice courtyard.
Go ahead.
Yeah, it's really nice. It's a cute little courtyard. It's a great place to have a drink or.
I love courtyards.
Yeah, I like it.
I've
that's where I go if you
I've been
looking
courtyard
for me.
Before.
Yeah, it looks good now. So.
About how long do you think it takes to actually make this dish, Rachel, from, let's say, start to finish?
Well, if you're starting with the dough itself, I'd say you could make it even in 30 minutes. But,
30 minutes.
You know, I mean, that's me. Maybe double it if you don't have a lot of experience with the dough. But it's pretty simple. Everyone I've taught at the restaurant can't believe how simple it is. And, I mean, you can even make dough, fresh pasta, and dry it yourself, too.
Wow.
So if you want to, you can make it. And
make it last longer.
Mm-hmm. Just the same as what you buy.
Well, tell everybody at home, how would you go about drying the pasta?
After you're done rolling it, you could literally... When I was in France, when we learned in France, they would literally hang it on dowels, like wooden dowels, and just hang it over so it could dry. That's it. It takes like a day to dry.
Really? Mm-hmm.
Okay. And if you don't want to dry it, you can just refrigerate it, put it in plastic wrap, cover it with plastic, and then it keeps in your refrigerator for a couple of weeks.
Sounds great.
Yeah.
Okay, Rachel, we're going to take a small break, and then we're going to let you come back, and she's going to show us how to actually prepare the dough. So join us back for more What's Cooking in just a few minutes.